Does your idea of being an office worker mean working in dark, cramped, cluttered, old-fashioned rooms and possibly using outdated office systems and equipment?
Type out this, please. It needs some double spacing and relaying out.
Yeah.
And that's for the meeting this afternoon.
Fine.
If you can type in capitals or something.
Right.
Okay, thanks very much.
Nowadays, it doesn't have to be like that. Word processor. One of the most commonly used items of modern office equipment is found in both large corporations and small companies alike. Julie left school recently to start on an office career with a specialist recruitment company. Even though she's working in bright modern surroundings where all the staff have the benefit of the latest office equipment, she still has to learn the traditional office skills.
License division.
Yes, it is.
The official title is office junior, but I do mainly the same work as the other girls. Yes. Typing, filing, talking to candidates on the phone, arranging interviews.
Basically, we're a recruitment consultancy for medical representatives. We find jobs for you, take details, with an application form, send your application form, and send your details out to various companies.
Okay, that's fine. Hold on a moment, please, Mr. Wills.
Jenny,
can you pass me the diary, please?
Hello, Mr. Wills. When would you like to come and see Miss Barringer?
I wouldn't mind progressing on, you know, well, a good promotion or becoming secretary. I don't want to staff as junior all the time.
The week's starting the 29th.
As a lot of the company's paperwork is confidential, one of Julie's jobs is to make sure the unwanted papers are destroyed when no longer required.
Good morning, sales division. I like seeing the different people. I like talking to different people on the phone as well. Talking to different candidates and different clients and seeing the different candidates that come up here.
Your initials? Fine. Did you see an advertisement of ours anywhere?
Hello, can I help you?
When I was at school, I always felt that I wouldn't go into an office job because it was so boring. Or from the outside looking in, it seemed so boring. But this job, really, I wanted to take just to tide me over until I could find something else, but I like working here.
Collie, Mr. Stanton's here.
Thank you, Julie.
Okay.
Julie's school typing course made using a word processor easier.
I prefer using a word processor because it's a lot easier. And you can go back on your own words if you've made mistakes. And the machine does it for you. It's very easy.
So how do you learn to use a word processor?
Good morning, girls. Welcome to the...
Judy Kidd is employed by a company selling word processors and is starting a three-day instruction course for their clients, secretaries and typists. She'll explain how the word processor works and teach people how to make the most use of it.
Now, just because... the typewriter is going to become an obsolete item in the next 5 years. It doesn't mean that you have to forget all those newly learnt typing skills that you've brought out of school with you. In front of you, you'll see that you have a screen with a detachable keyboard, two disk drives here, and a panel of keys on the right-hand side. These are the keys that we're going to be learning over the next 3 days. The same as I have on the flip chart here, you have a green execute key and a red cancel key. So whenever you give the system a command, you either say execute, yes, go ahead, or cancel. If you'd like to come round to this machine, I'd like to demonstrate to you. Here you have the cursor, the little green shadow of light that I was telling you about. As I press my cursor directional key here, to the right, you see that the cursor moves along one space at a time. And it counts up here for me, H for horizontal. You see that it's counting as I move across the page. The center key here is called my home cursor key. If I press it twice, it takes me home. Home to the left-hand margin at the top of the page. The first thing you have to do when beginning any piece of work is to set your left and your right-hand margin. On the word processor, we simply take the cursor to where we want to set the margin. Up there, H30, character position 30, you press your format key and L for left. We go over to the right-hand side and we set our right-hand margin. Once again, format key and R for right. We're now ready to begin typing. Before we begin to type, we must put in a working disk. A small floppy disk that has 69 segments available to you, each segment holding about 1,000 characters, 35 pages of A4 text. You take the disk between your thumb and forefinger, the label pointing uppermost to the ceiling, and you place it in the disk drive here, and you close the door.
A large modern office can achieve better productivity and make working conditions more interesting and pleasant for their staff in many ways. In this large modern headquarters building, there are many different types of modern office equipment. However, some jobs still require the older methods of working. Susan Evans is one of a team working in the revenue expenditure department. She deals with bills received from outside contractors, checks them, and passes them for payment, all without the aid of modern office equipment, except for a small desk calculator.
Right, you are. Bye-bye.
Well, I left school and went to college for 2 months. I was doing a nursing course, and I didn't like that. So I left and became a shop assistant, and I didn't like that either. When I was unemployed for 5 weeks, the job centre people said that there were courses available, clerical courses, catering courses, all sorts. There was one at Southern Gas, so I applied for it and started in March. After I'd gone through 4 months, I was then made temporary in the personnel department, where I applied for a job in revenue expenditure and was successful in that one. I'm in charge of 3 areas, Bournemouth, Oxford and Southampton, and I deal with all their invoices for private contractors and the local authorities, and if they've got any queries they come to me, but if anybody's away I take over their areas as well. When we've received invoices from the local authorities or private contractors for the work that they've carried out, we have to get them ready for payment.
Jerry? Mm-hmm. Yeah, what's this problem?
Yes.
Can you tell me what code that one will be there?
We have to process invoices by coding them, sending them to area for approval. When they've come back, we have to make out pay slips and then send them through for payment by another department.
Susan is allowed to deal with bills of amounts up to £500. Bills of a higher value are handled by a senior colleague. An important aspect of many modern companies are the benefits offered to the staff, like a restaurant facility. Here there's the usual self-service counter, but there's also a waitress service area which is not reserved for management. Anyone who wishes may use it, but it costs a little more. In fact, whichever part of the restaurant you select, you're just as likely to be sitting next to a departmental manager as a typist. Over the years, office workers have come to regard the typing pool as one of the most inefficient and therefore unpopular departments in a company. But in this very efficient department, nearly all the typing services for the company are provided using word processors and a few electric typewriters. This bank of dictation machines does away with the need for a lot of full-time secretaries. From your office, you can dictate a letter by phone to be typed.
Hello?
But as with all modern technology, you have to know how to use the system.
Yeah, you press one. Yeah. Yeah, you just got, and if you want to go back into playback, press one, keep your finger down and it goes back. Okay. Okay, bye.
Once you know how to use it, it's simplicity itself.
This is a letter on A5 paper to Mrs. S. Wright, 3 Hillside View, Portsmouth. Dear Mrs. Wright, thank you for your inquiry made in our showroom on the 8th of June, full stop, paragraph.
The service department in Portsmouth have asked me to reduce your account by £2.09 as it was priced incorrectly, full stop. Would you please accept my apologies for this error on our part? Yours faithfully.
When the typist has finished your letter, she instructs the word processor to print it. This happens in a separate area where the room temperature is strictly controlled as the machinery is spoilt by too much heat. Each word processor is linked to the disk drive machine so that your letter just sent for typing joins the queue of waiting correspondence and is printed in its turn. The printers, typing both left to right and right to left, work at an average speed of 500 words a minute, whereas a good typist can only manage about 50 words a minute. Also handled by the typing centre is the Post Office Telex system, enabling urgent messages to be instantly sent anywhere in the world. Most office staff say filing is one of the most boring jobs of their life. Now, to save time and especially space, a considerable amount of paperwork is microfilmed. Using a few rolls of microfilm instead of rows of filing cabinets saves a vast amount of office space. After the film has been checked for any mistakes, the original paperwork can then be destroyed. In the microfilm department, they have several cameras, and between them, they photograph some 10,000 pieces of paper a day. This cabinet of microfilms in the department, which looks after some customers' bills, holds the records of over 100,000 budget account applications. A budget account customer wanting to check his bill can phone into the department. When he quotes his reference number, the clerk can punch up current details of his bill on a visual display unit, which is linked to the main computer.
Yeah, have you got your reference number, sir? All right, could you hold on a minute then, please?
Yes.
Well, at the moment, your account is £1.36 in debit. We've received full payments from you and rendered you with two charges, one of £32.92
from the 10th of June. I'm 6844. Okay, thank you then. Bye-bye.
It only takes a minute or two to give an accurate report of a customer's bill. The old photocopiers and duplicators couldn't cope with the mountain of photocopying required by a modern organisation. In the reprographics department, there are electrostatic photocopiers, which, together with some ancillary equipment, will reproduce as many copies as needed of items like reports, daily office information sheets, the chairman's statement, and press releases. Then, if required, the papers can be sorted, stapled, bound together, and labelled before dispatch. The much underrated postroom, where everything used to be done by hand, is becoming more mechanised. Machines now stuff papers into envelopes and seal them. Another machine stamps them. This postroom is able to send out about 33,000 items of mail a day. No matter how much modern equipment is used in the present-day postroom, there's still a great need for a post girl like June. Several times a day, she has to trundle her basket round the building to deliver and collect the post.
I was 16 when I left school. I had 3 O-levels, not very high grades. I did do office practice and I also did typing. I wrote to Southern Gas and I applied for the job in the post room and I got the job. I like going around the building meeting people. Get to see quite a lot of people, meet people. We deliver the post and we collect the outgoing post. We collect the area post, the internal post and the GPO. We keep them separate. When I first came here, I did want to go into a different department. But now that I'm used to the job, I don't want to move, no. I like it there. And I like the people that I work with too. So I don't want to move at the moment.
In the modern office, machines have not yet replaced people. The human touch is still necessary. But the introduction of new technology has improved efficiency and makes office work more interesting.